That you're doing well. Welcome to Ms. Fontaine Channel, your go-to destination for insightful and engaging educational content. Here, we explore a wide range of topics from science and history to technology and beyond. Prepare to expand your knowledge and spark your curiosity with our carefully crafted videos. Subscribe now and join us on our journey of discovery. In today's session, we're going to look at forensic entomology. And you're going to begin with a brief introduction of forensic entomology. And I find that forensic entomology is the study of the use of insects and other arthropods to aid in legal investigations. Examples of these insects, we have the blue flies, the beetles, that is the insects and other arthropods. I find that Bernard Greenberg is regarded as the father of modern forensic entomology. And the main areas of application of forensic entomology, we have insect damage to structures, we have infestation of foodstuffs, we have insects that inhabit human remains, etc. I'm going to briefly look at the historical landmarks in forensic entomology. We're going to begin with the year 1235. That is the in this year we have Sang Zhu, and this he was the first to use insect evidence to solve a crime. Then in the year 1668 we have Francisco Redi, who was the first to prove that maggots arise from eggs that are laid by flies, and he was discrediting the theory that maggots grew out of the rotting meat, In the 1855, we have Begret, who was the first to use entomology to estimate the postmortem interval, that is PMI. In the 1881, we have Hermann Reinhard, who was the first to systematically study exhumed bodies, as well as the insects that are associated with them. In the 1894, we have John, who was the first to identify the eight stages of human decomposition. And then in the year 1960, we have Jerry, who reduced the numbers or the stages of the number of decomposition stages to six. We've seen that in the year 1894, the stages that were identified were eight, but then in the year 1960s, these numbers were reduced, or the number of these stages was reduced. In the 1984, forensic entomology was accepted as a professional field of study. And then in the year 1996, forensic entomology was routinely used in legal investigations, especially those involving death. Those are the major or the important historical landmarks of or in forensic entomology. Going to look at applications of forensic entomology, and the first application is to in estimating the postmortem interval, that is PMI, and this uses for the PMI to be estimated, the type of insects found studied. And also, it's the major factors that are considered in this is the type of insect found, as well as the temperature the insects were found in. Some of the examples. Okay. The blue fly is an important insect when it comes to forensic entomology, and the study of the life cycle of the blue fly is important when that the blue fly, the blue fly is usually the first to arrive. That is when the state of the corpse is fresh. And the life cycle of a blue fly, we have eggs that are usually laid directly after death, that is about 0 to 23 hours. Then we have the first insta larvae, that is from 23 hours. Then we have the second insta larvae from 50 hours. We have the third insta larvae from 72 hours. Then you have the pupae, which is about from 202 hours. Then you have the adult blue fly, which is from 345 hours. That is about 14 to 15 days. And it comes to the study of beetles. Then we have the hairy roof beetle arrives within a day or a few days of the blue flies. That is, we have types of beetles. We have those that arrive first. We have others that show up weeks to months after death, like the hide beetle. So the study of the life cycle of these insects and arthropods is important when it comes to estimating the postmortem interval. Another application of forensic entomologists is determining if a body was moved. We find that different types of insects are found in different geographical locations depending on the weather. So if a certain type of insect is found where it's or it's found in a different place that is not its habitat, then that shows that there was some movement of the body in question. It is also applied in determining the geographical location of death. That is also by considering the types of insects present and their habitat, their usual habitat. It's also used to identify cases of neglect or abuse. We find that insects that are found on living individuals are symptoms or are telltale signs of neglect or abuse. They also applied in indicating a wound or where a wound was. Find that where there is maggot activity, or rather maggot activities occur away from natural openings. In these natural openings, you have the mouth, have the nose, ears, etc. If there is a maggot activity that is in any other place apart from the natural openings, that shows there was a wound. It's also used to show the source of contraband, that is applying the knowledge of different insects have all are found in different geographical locations. Identification of area of trauma in extensively decomposed body, that is the same as that one, indicating the presence of a wound. We also have entomotoxicology, that is the presence of drugs in a corpse. And entomotoxicology is the analysis of drugs and toxins on the development rates of carrion feeding insects. And when it comes to this study or this analysis, when we come to the evidence collection, some equipments are needed, which include a fine paint brush, that is for collecting eggs, forceps for collecting adults and more fragile immature insects. We have a hand net for catching flying insects, 70% ethanol for storing dead specimen. We have protocol sheets that used to write down what specimen was collected. We have labels, we have storage boxes, we have sawdust or tissue paper for handling eggs. We have shovels, robust plastic bags, that is for soil samples. We also have thermometers, we have cameras for photographic evidence. Yeah, those are the various applications of forensic entomology. We are going to look at the limitations of forensic entomology. Forensic entomology relies heavily on insect abundance. We find that in winter, there are fewer insects. This applies the or affects the application of forensic entomology. The second limitation is that some treatments like freezing and others that exclude insects can affect the estimates, because some of them can delay when the insects come in. So in as much as the calculations of the life cycles are done correctly, the insects came later than they should because of these treatments. So the estimates are not going to be in the accurate range. Also, it takes time to rear insects, hence forensic entomology can't produce immediate results. Therefore, we say it's time consuming. Those are the various limitations of forensic entomology. We've come to the end of our session.